Have a nice time. In this video, we will prove two results. First one is every field is an integral domain, and the next result is every finite integral domain is a field. So let us prove the theorem. Every field F is an integral domain. In the last class, you were introduced to the concept of integral domains. An integral domain is a commutative ring with unity and without having any zero divisors. And you already studied about the concept of fields. Field is again a commutative ring with unity in which every non-zero elements are units. So that is, every non-zero element must have a multiplicative inverse. Here we consider a field F and we are to show that F is an integral domain. So which is the additional property we want to prove? We have to show that F has no zero divisors. So assume that F is a field, and to show that F is an integral domain, it is enough to show that F has no zero divisors. So we take two elements, A, B belong to F, and we assume that this element A is not equal to zero, and assume A into B equal to zero in F. We already assumed that A not equal to zero. If B is also not equal to zero, then A and B are divisors of zero in F. Here we may note that since A is an element of F and F is a field, every non-zero element are units. That is, every non-zero element in F has a multiplicative inverse. Therefore, since A not equal to 0, A has a multiplicative inverse, and let it be denoted by 1 by A. So if we multiply 1 by A with AB, actually we get 1 by A into B, since multiplication is associative in a ring. And this is equal to 1 by A into A is the multiplicative identity 1, 1 into B, and which equals B. But actually 1 by A into AB equal to 1 by A into, as per our assumption, A into B equal to 0. So this is 1 by A into 0. So this is equal to 0. So LHS of these two equations are equal. Therefore we can conclude that B equal to 0. So whenever we take two elements AB belong to F with A not equal to 0 and A into B equal to 0, then that B must be equal to 0. Therefore, in F there are no divisors of 0. In other words, F is an integral domain. So we can conclude that every field is an integral domain. Now we are going to prove the theorem. A finite integral domain is a field. To prove the theorem, we take D as a finite integral domain, and we have to show that this D is a field. And for D to be a field, it must be a commutative ring with unity and in which every non-zero elements are units. As per our assumption, D is an integral domain. Therefore, D is a commutative ring with unity. Therefore, these two first two conditions are satisfied, and now it is enough to show that in D, every non-zero elements are units. So we take a non-zero element in D, and we are sure that this element A is a unit in D. That means that A must have a multiplicative inverse in D. That is, we have to show that there exists an element B belong to D such that A into B equal to 1. Then this B becomes the multiplicative inverse of A. So to prove the result, we consider D as the set 0, 1, then it contains some more elements A1, A2, A3, etc, AN. How can we take D as such a set? Here, given that D is a finite integral domain, therefore D contains only finitely many elements. And since D is an integral domain, it is actually a ring, and in any ring, D with addition is an abelian group. Therefore, D contains the additive identity 0. So 0 belongs to D. And since D is an integral domain, as per the definition of integral domains, it contains the unity. That is, D contains the multiplicative identity 1. Therefore 1 also belongs to D. So that is why we take these two elements 0 and 1 in D, and we consider the other elements in D are A1, A2, etc, AN. So this is now the set D. So actually this element A belong to D we had taken earlier is one of the elements in D. And since A not equal to 0, it is not the element 0 here, but it may be 1, A1, A2, etc, AN. Now we consider the elements A into 1, a into a1, a into a2, etc., a into am. That is, we multiply the element a with each of the elements of the set D, except 0. These elements a into 1, a into a1, a into a2, etc., a into an are all elements of D. Now we are going to show that these n plus 1 elements are all distinct. That is, a into 1, a into a1, a into a2, etc., a into an are distinct elements in D. To prove the result, we will take two elements. In general, I can take a into ai equal to a into aj. Since D is an integral domain and a, ai, aj are all elements of D, by left cancellation law, we can conclude that ai equal to aj. In the last video, we have already showed that left and right cancellation laws hold in a ring if there is no divisors of 0. And in an integral domain, there is no divisors of 0. Therefore, we can use the left cancellation law here and we can write ai equal to aj. So, what we get? A into ai equal to a into aj implies ai equal to aj. Or in other words, if ai not equal to aj, then a into ai not equal to a into aj. Therefore, all the elements in this set are distinct. And these are elements in D actually. Therefore, these n plus 1 elements, a into 1, a into a1, etc., a into an, are distinct elements of D, which may be 1, a1, a2, etc., an in some order. So, I can write here D as the set 0, 1, a1, a2, etc., an, which is equal to the set 0, then a into 1, a into a1, a into a2, etc., a into an. Since these two sets are equal, one of the elements here equal to the element 1. Therefore, we can conclude that either a into 1 equal to 1 or a into ai equal to 1 for some I belong to 1, 2, etc., n. If a into 1 equal to 1, it means that a equal to 1. That is, the element a we had taken itself is the multiplicative identity and it has multiplicative inverse 1 itself. And if a into ai equal to 1, that means that ai is the multiplicative inverse of a. So, if we take an element a belong to D such that a not equal to 0, then we arrived at the result that either a equal to 1 or a has a multiplicative inverse in D. Therefore, every non-zero elements in D are units. Since D is already an integral domain, it is a commutative ring with unity also. Therefore, we can conclude that D is a field. So, we proved the important result, a finite integral domain is a field.